following is a special NHL on ESPN presentation.
What's it like to score a goal in the National Hockey League?
Every time was a great feeling.
Ovechkin fires, goal!
If I hit the goalie, you know, he's lucky. If I hit the empty spot, it's in.
Alexander Ovechkin.
Hi, I'm Alex Ovechkin. Alexander Ovechkin.
For only the third time in history, a player has reached 800 goals. What once seemed impossible now seems entirely probable.
If you would ask me that 15 years ago, I would have thought, no chance. But he's going to make a run at it.
Alexander Ovechkin, welcome on board!
Every year, it doesn't matter. It's 50 goals, 50 goals. He finds a way.
Ovi will be remembered, I think, is the greatest goal scorer of all time.
Oh, I think we're past the point of if. I think we all know it's a matter of time.
He scores! Ovechkin!
Oh, what a shot!
Does this kid ever love to score goals?
Wayne Gretzky, number 802. Wayne Gretzky, the great one, has become the greatest of them all.
Sometimes you look at the milestones, but I'm not done yet.
Let's go! Alex Ovechkin! Yeah! Yeah! Only one great left to hunt down, and that's the great one.
If you do something, you have to be the best all the time. So if you don't want to be the best, just stop doing it.
Welcome to a special presentation of the NHL on ESPN. Greatness. Alex Ovechkin's chase for hockey immortality. I'm John Butchergrass. After recently passing Gordie Howe's total of 801 career goals, the Washington Capitals winger now sits second behind only the great one, Wayne Gretzky, in his career 894 goals. Over the next hour, we'll hear from the Great Eight and look back at his on-ice hockey journey, from Ovechkin's pregame preparations to his mastery of the one-timer, to how he plans to claim his place in hockey history. It's a story nearly 20 years in the making, as told by our own Kevin Weeks.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the 2004 National Hockey League Entry Draft. The first selection belongs to the Washington Capitals.
I was nervous, obviously, because, it was lots of great players up there. I was like, maybe they're not going to take me.
Alexander Ovechkin was one of the best foundations you could ever get in terms of rehabilitating your franchise.
Despite his own doubts, Alexander Ovechkin was a consensus number one overall pick coming into the 2004 NHL Entry Draft. A generational talent heralded by scouts as the best prospect since Merrill Lemieux.
I think he was an automatic pick. The strength, the power, the physicality, the ability to score goals. He had a complete package that would translate to the NHL game fairly quickly by anybody that was watching.
My earliest memory was probably the World Junior Tournament. At that point in time, everyone was talking about Ovi, and I watched him closely. He is one of three players that I saw in my lifetime that had the unique ability to be extremely physical, yet combine that with finesse and hockey sense. And the only other two guys that I ever saw that were in that level were probably Gordie Howe, Mark Messier. And so right from a young age, I saw what he had.
My agent and he just like, well, you're probably going to be first. I said, no, like, I have to like listen, wait and hear my name.
With the first selection, 2004 NHL entry draft, Washington Capitals are pleased to select Alexander Ovechkin.
Alexander Ovechkin, one of those special players who was projected in the first overall at the age of 14.
Yeah, I'm very proud of this. I'm very happy. I'm very happy.
To be honest, I never thought like I'm gonna be able to score 800 goals in the NHL. I'd be crazy if I came to the draft and tell George McPhee, you know what, if you're gonna draft me, like I'm gonna score 800. It's impossible.
I have a dream to play in the NHL, and my dreams come true. And right now, we have one goal to win Stanley Cup.
What did it feel like for you when you first got to DC?
It was kind of weird because, I stayed in a hotel and it was a kind of weird room. Like, it was not like first floor, second floor, it was minus one floor.
No way.
Yeah, like I was in kind of in a jail, you know? No English, don't understand language, sure. No TV, and I have only small window, you know?
Yep.
So I'm sitting and I'm like, geez, but what am I doing here? You know?
Washington Capitals begin the 05-06 season against the Columbus Blue Jackets.
October 5th, 2005 versus Columbus, your first NHL game. What happened in the second period?
Two goals.
Nines, Zubra spins, Ovechkin fires, he scores! Alexander Ovechkin, welcome on board! Here on Why Not, LeClaire the save.
I said I scored first goal in NHL in first game. There and I promise, and I scored.
I feel great.
Yeah.
My parents, my brother, all my friends watching me kind of give me emotion, give me happiness.
Scoring goals has been a lifelong passion for Ovechkin, dating back to his earliest days in Russia's capital of Moscow, where he honed his skills at his grandfather's country house.
I remember we have wood nets. We have like maybe 10 pucks, and we put the bottles, plastic bottles, on top of the posts and crossbars. And
those are your targets?
Yeah, this is my target. And I have to hit each to be free to go out and play. Back then, I didn't want to do it. I just want to play with the kids on the street. But I'm pretty sure that kind of helped me when I was growing up.
Ovechkin fires and scores! Alexander Ovechkin, OV in OT for the win!
So we have a rookie party before the game.
The night before?
No, not the night before. I think it was two nights before. So rookie dinner, everything.
All the stuff, all the good stuff.
Yeah, all the good stuff.
Yeah.
And I remember in the morning skate, like I was like, she's like, I don't feel good. I don't.
What?
Yeah, I don't feel like, 100%. Still.
Now, is it stomach?
No, still like a little,
Yes. A little off.
Yeah. So, well, okay, this is my rookie dinner, I have to do what I have to do.
Sure.
So, and that goal happened.
it happened.
Maybe, yeah, maybe because of the night before.
Ovechkin storming in. Alexander Ovechkin curl and drag to the back end. He scores! Simply sensational!
This may be his prettiest goal of the season. A spectacular display of stick handling on his back.
When you first went down, like, what were you thinking when you first got down?
Just tried to hit the puck. I remember, like, I thought I just want to hit the puck. Like, maybe I hit it or maybe I not.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is the goal of the year. We have a winner.
Do you realize who was coaching that game?
Wayne Gretzky.
So even Wayne Gretzky, the great one, is going to see how this one went in.
Well, first of all, I hated it because I was coaching against him. But no, from a pure talent and awe sort of point of view, it has to be one of the greatest goals that was ever scored in the NHL.
Do you know who else was in the building that game?
Matthews?
Austin Matthews. A young Austin Matthews as a little boy.
I still get chills from it, honestly, thinking about it, because I still remember it, like, pretty vividly. It was just, like, silent, like nobody could believe what just happened. Everybody kept looking up at the scoreboard and it was just crazy.
I look at the right away and Jumbotron. Say, oh, wow, that's a pretty good goal. But I never know, nobody knew like it's gonna be that goal.
That goal, the goal, launched Ovechkin to a new level of stardom. He attracted attention not only for his unique highlight reel plays, but for his unique style, his trademark yellow laces, and mirrored visor.
He scores! Ovechkin in overtime! Does this kid ever love to score goals?
I don't want to be like any player. So I just decided, okay, I'm going to use the yellow shoes. I'm going to have a different visor.
Big play!
As the goals piled up for Ovechkin, opposing goalies reportedly complained to the league that the visor gave him an unfair advantage.
Brodeur started crying to the league. I can see his eyes. What are you talking about? So the league said, like, I can't wear visor. But you guys always crying.
Not, well, who you mean, the goalies?
Yeah. But then Gary, of course, Ovechkin again. Yes. Bring him back, Gary.
That's what I'm asking. Are we going to get to see it again?
Like, I would love to have
it. Yeah, would you rock it? You'd rock it for sure?
Oh, yeah.
100%.
Yeah, I would love to.
The way you celebrate, man, when you score. I've always loved that because you have so much enthusiasm.
Ovechkin fires, he scores! Alex Ovechkin!
Early in your career, they're like, why is he celebrating? Why is he sitting now? They weren't always saying that when somebody else scored, but when you scored, sometimes they were saying that.
Now watch Ovechkin. Look at this. Does Dion remind you of a soccer player? Look at this guy. You don't act like this goof. This is goofy stuff. I am predicting somebody's going to get him. And somebody's going to get them good.
How'd that make you feel at the time?
Laugh. You play for the fans, right?
Totally.
The fans wants to see your emotions. The fans wants to see a celebration. Can you imagine if everybody's like gonna listen to someone said, don't celebrate goals. So you score a goal and go back, sit on the bench, not smiling, nothing?
Exactly.
Crazy.
Ovechkin scored 52 goals in his first season, the third highest total ever. He also won Rookie of the Year.
Chance for Ovechkin, he scores!
In 07-08, he took it to another level, scoring 65 goals, the most since Mario Lemieux in 1996. In his first three seasons, Ovechkin scored 163 times. emerging as the most prolific goal scorer in a generation. Do you ever feel bad for the goalies, for us? You ever feel bad when you score, in game or in practice?
In practice, no. In game, yes.
Coming up, Alex Ovechkin sets the league on fire. We break down the craftsman, his tools, and the most dangerous weapon in the NHL.
His one-timer, it has a little more zip than most people do.
Ovi's open, one-timer, score!
The chase for greatness continues next.
Six of the shots on goal, Montreal leading 1-0. And Komisarek is back to pick it up. And he goes for Hamrlik as both teams change. Hamrlik can't get there. What a move by Ovechkin. In comes Ovechkin. In front. What a goal by Alexander Ovechkin. Unstoppable.
Like any master of a craft, 37-year-old Alex Ovechkin is particular about his tools. What's your relationship like with your sticks?
That's most important thing. I changed my curve maybe twice during my career. Sometimes I use different sticks, you know, just messed up, but I have a red cord, like a green one.
Right.
I love it.
And what about the flex?
100.
100 flex.
So every time before the game, like cut 2 or 3 sticks, feel them, look at the curve, look at the shaft, and then I pick one. Tape 2, put it on an extra stick, like if it's broken.
And do you always do your sticks yourself?
Yeah.
Always?
Always. I don't trust no one.
The craftsman, his tools, and his office. They all come together at the left wing circle, above the dot. Grace and power combined.
Back to Green. Looks to Ovechkin for the one-timer, score!
His one-timer, I think, is second to none. It has a little more zip than most people's do, and his ability to control where it goes more times than not is phenomenal.
I think with Alex, it's just his sweet spot is so wide. I mean, he doesn't have to get the pass perfect all times.
Ovechkin, one-timer, he scores! Ovi's open, one-timer, goal! You know it's coming! And you still can't stop it.
It's hard to understand how he makes every goal so easy, right? He's got something inside of him that he always knows where he has to be and where to shoot.
Shoots hard. So like he's like pretty close enough, and one-timers are hard to read, you know, to see if they're going left or right or low, right? And you know, you try to cover as much net as you can, you know, but he's still able to hit those balls in corners.
When did you start working on the one-timer and the slapper?
I think it's when I came to NHL. I think we started doing that power play. They put me on that spot. Just came natural.
He's got that hunger for scoring that I've never seen in anyone before.
I'm happy for myself when I score a goal. I'm happy for my teammates score goals. It's just give you energy, give you, you know, kind of extra emotions, extra power.
Putting 1-on-3, Ovechkin, the wrist shot, scores! Alex Ovechkin, his 50th goal of the season.
That's how I stick.
Yep.
I still have it in my basement.
Is it still on fire?
Yeah.
Ovechkin's basement has become a somewhat mythical place, housing over 200 of his own sticks, each telling its own story.
I collect every point since last year, I think. I collect every point and every goal. This is season 2008-2009, all the milestones, all the hat tricks, 400 career points. It's just for me, and it's just for, it's gonna be in my family, it's gonna be in a museum, and it's gonna be like, you know, historical moments.
Scoring goals is a huge part of Ovechkin's game. But it isn't the only thing to make an impact.
Thrashtus comes crashing into the glass near the penalty box area. The glass shatters.
I can't remember who told me that, but when you came to NHL, you have to be strong enough to protect yourself. I tried to get a hit and take a hit as well.
When you play against O, you got to be aware of where he's at. You hope that he's not in the hitting mood that night, because if he is, chances are you're going down.
I'm lucky enough to be healthy. Of course, like, I have a couple injuries. Of course, sometimes sure. You play with the injuries.
Of course.
But, yeah, but not major.
Hit or be hit. Despite the countless hits he's given and received in nearly two decades, Ovechkin has only missed 27 games.
Right away when we finish, season's done, we tell the date when we're gonna start with my trainer. He tried to see how bad shape I am right now, you know. We talk a lot about what we're gonna do, like today we're gonna do like cardio, gym, you know, movements. But most of the time, it's basically the same thing.
He's a strong man. When he comes to camp, he's got a strength to him that's probably always been like a man's strength.
Longevity and performance for the modern day athlete have long been connected to strict conditioning and nutrition. There's Tom Brady, but then there's the Alex Ovechkin diet.
Diet? Actually, I can't say that he has any diet. He eats pasta, he really loves meatballs.
In Washington, I have only one meal, spaghetti and sauces. On the road, like, I eat salad, I eat soup, I eat spaghetti and chicken broccoli.
What's in your water bottle during game?
Coke.
And why?
My first year of season, my trainer told me, like, he was a professional marathon guy. He said, what they do for energy, they drink Coke. Yeah. I don't know if it gives me energy or not. Maybe it's just like something, but.
Yeah. Seems like it's working.
Seems you know what I mean? Yeah, yeah.
The tools, the talent, the power, and the parm. Put all of this together, and you have the makings of a goal-scoring savant.
Ovechkin rips, he scores! Welcome to the club, number 500 for the grade eights.
It's an unlikely combination, but one that has made Ovechkin one of the most consistent goal scorers in league history, having scored 50 goals in 9 of his 18 seasons.
With all these years, he's been doing this at a top level at all time. I mean, it's just, it has been incredible to watch him. I mean, people has been saying that he's gonna slow down, but he doesn't do it. It's just, it's not part of his DNA, I think.
Alex Ovechkin was a generational talent, but Wayne Gretzky and now Sidney Crosby, among others, were champions.
How did that motivate you? How did that impact you?
When Chicago won, when LA won, when Tampa won a couple of years ago, bites you.
The chase for greatness continues next.
Alex and I have known each other over the years. They came out west for a trip and they had a couple days. We set up a dinner.
You know, we have a great time, you know, talking about hockey, talking about life. Drink a beer and, you know, just have fun.
It reminded me so much of me being a kid sitting with Gordie Howe. I just couldn't talk enough hockey. I couldn't ask him enough things.
Howe shoots, he scores! Gordie Howe!
For decades, Gordie Howe owned the title as the greatest scorer in NHL history with 801 goals. In 1994, the torch was passed over to the great one, Wayne Gretzky.
McSorley to Gretzky! He did it! The greatest goal scorer in National Hockey League history!
Gordie followed me around when I got to 800, 801. And my dad tapped me on the shoulder and he said, one day somebody's gonna come along and somebody's gonna break your record. And you make sure you're as gracious to them as Gordie Howe is to you.
At the time of the dinner, Ovechkin was 30 and had 516 career goals, over halfway towards Gretzky's 894.
We talked mostly about the team itself and being a captain and trying to become a Stanley Cup champion. It's one thing to set records, but we'll tell you all to a man, that doesn't mean anything compared to lifting the Stanley Cup.
Gretzky finished with four Stanley Cups. Ovechkin had yet to win one.
I'm kind of a lucky person who have a chance to meet the great one. In the end, I asked him a stick.
And what happened?
He said, well, when you're going to win the cup, I'll give you one.
I said, I'm not sending you one before you score 700 and win the cup.
It's the seemingly preordained second round showdown between the Penguins and the Capitals. Third straight year they meet, two of the game's biggest stars, Crosby and Ovechkin.
We've been watching these guys for 13 wonderful seasons. What more is there to say?
Alex Ovechkin was 20 years old when he and Sidney Crosby both entered the league in 2005.
Hey, Ovechkin fires, he scores!
They would become the faces of the NHL for the next two decades.
Ovechkin is going to score!
While building a rivalry for the ages.
That's intense. That's basically the way to describe it. It's intense rivalry, and it's built up over the last few years.
We got action here. Ovechkin and Crosby.
It's a rivalry, and that's enough to say about it.
Through their first 13 seasons, both players scored over 1,100 points. In fact, the difference between them was only 6 points. But there was something more glaring.
With the bitter disappointment of having been eliminated by the Penguins.
Crosby would defeat Ovechkin in each of their three playoff meetings, which led to three Stanley Cups.
His rivalry partner started winning a couple of cups. That's when he started to compare where Sidney was in his career, and Alex had no cup.
It was kind of give you more motivation. You try to show you're a better player than him. You know, you try to more score, try to score more goals, more hits, more assists, whatever. And then you try to win the game.
One strike away for the Caps from a meeting with Tampa Bay in the conference final.
Tight.
It is
tight.
Ovechkin moving back. He gives it on to Kuznetsov, moving on in.
Yeah!
He's got final for the first time in 19 years.
When did you start feeling the vibes in that run?
When we passed the second round. Finally. You know, against Pittsburgh, finally. And then, like, you know, it was kind of like clicking.
Kuznetsov to Ovechkin. He scores! Bet on to Kuznetsov to Ovechkin. Scores! The first time in two decades, the Caps are headed to the big show.
It's been a long time. Come on, boys, let's do this.
We knew, like, they don't have a chance because, like, we knew, like, how powerful we are.
It's Pet across. Score! Ovechkin! Backstrom just holding. Ovechkin! Score! Everyone standing in the arena.
Capitals have won it! The Washington Capitals, for the first time in their 44-year history, are the Stanley Cup champions.
When they won the Stanley Cup, it was something incredible. He felt such a relieved.
Ovechkin, now 32 years old, had 15 goals in the 2018 playoffs and would go on to win the Conn Smythe Trophy.
I think that showed everyone else and maybe some of the critics that had not seen him get to that point that that he is for real and he is one of the best to ever play.
Alex Ovechkin, it's your honor. Come on up. Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! It was the best atmosphere ever. I don't want to go nowhere. I just want to celebrate in the room.
Wow, man.
Like, it was crazy. It was crazy.
I just got goosebumps with you even saying that.
It was probably the best feeling I have, like, with the team. You know what I mean?
Before the year, I said, not me say, it's just us saying, we're not gonna be sucked this year. We're the Stanley Cup champions! Yeah! Woo!
Yeah! When did the boys set the level?
Our celebration. I think Osh started that crazy lip thing. They put me on top.
Yeah.
I take one zip of the beer and I was like, oh. Yeah. It feels like you're drunk right away. Yeah. It feels like you drink like six shots of water.
Two years after becoming a champion, this happened.
Kuznetsov for Ovechkin, drive! He scores! His spectacular history-making continues. 700 red lights.
6 weeks later.
Oi, what do you think?
Okay. I found a game used stick and I had it sent to him. I didn't touch it. I sent it the exact same way it was, and he was pretty excited to get it.
But it wasn't just any stick.
Tapped ahead. Tocket moves it up to Gretzky. Empty net to shoot at. He finds it.
It was the stick used by Gretzky to score goal 807. Serving as a reminder for Alex of where he's been.
Yeah, baby!
And where you could still go.
Thanks, Wayne. Appreciate it.
It's gonna take a while for the next milestone, but he's making you believe that it can be done.
Still to come, an all-access look at the historic moments that put Alex Ovechkin into the 800 club.
A shot, they score!
And an answer to the all-important question, can the Great Eight pass the Great One?
The greatest goal scorer in National Hockey League history!
Is it start to seem more real to get Gretz's now?
No, everything can happen.
ESPN!
It's a practice day at the Washington Capitals facility, but it sure doesn't sound like it. More than 800 kids gathered here. The hockey world, big and small, can't take their eyes off.
You listen to fans, you know, you read the papers, and you, like, put pressure on yourself. So right now, like, I don't care what the people saying, I don't care what somebody thought or thinking, and I'm just go out there and do my thing.
Alexander Ovechkin begins his 18th season with 780 goals. Puck is down, and we are underway from Capital One Arena. Johansson elevates beautifully. Ovechkin feeds down low. Deflection, score!
Alex Ovechkin has his first of the year.
As the 2022-23 season began,
come on, Q, let's go, baby.
There were two milestones within Ovechkin's reach.
You are watching a great piece of history.
First, could he become the third member of the 800-goal club? And then, could he pass Gordie Howe for second all-time with goal number 802?
Kuznetsov, long-range slapper, deflection, score! Off of Ovechkin and in!
The ability is just to evolve. I mean, he's got a big shot, but a big shot can only get you so far. I mean, it doesn't just get you 800 goals, you got a big shot. So he's found so many ways to do it, and consistency is the biggest one.
Gustafsson sets it, Ovechkin fires! There's the constant dub! A Bouchard 90! Alex Ovechkin cherry-picking for another 796th goal. For the empty net scores, number 797. Alex Ovechkin one closer to 800.
It was hard for Gordy to get 800. It was hard for me to get 800. Because if it was easy, then everybody would get 800 goals. It's really difficult. It's hard to do.
Against Chicago, before the game, I said, listen, I'm going to score three tonight.
No.
Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Wow.
Puck drops and we're underway.
We were sitting on the bench and we were like, he's going to do it. And you kind of just got that feeling. He looked like he had that look in his eye, typical Ovi fashion.
Connor Sherry coming in along the right side, and now they score, and it's Alex Ovechkin knocking on the door of history. It's 798.
Are you open, man?
I think so.
24 seconds in, Capitals are on the board. Wow.
Can you imagine first shift you score a goal? Second shift or third shift you score another goal.
Milano trying to center here, Sherry. Low, and now the chance he scores! The puck for Alex Ovechkin tapped in at the long post. That is 799. He is one away.
So you know, like, you have 60 minutes left
to do your thing.
To score one more goal.
Starting it now, the turnover in front, and Anthony feeding it to Kuznetsov, and Mrazek diving, a shot, they score! Alex Ovechkin is the third player in National Hockey League history to score 800 goals!
They're seeing one of the best ever right here tonight.
They are all standing and shouting his name. They get, listen to this crowd.
What a way to get 800.
He got a little shocked, I think, that we showered him, but I mean, there's only three people who scored 800 goals in the NHL, so hopefully he was proud.
When you have it, when you feel the taste, you want more and more.
guys in the hockey world. We'll be looking at number 8, who's sitting on 800, one shy of second all-time behind, of course, Mr. Hockey.
Gordie Howe off the defender and wide of the goal.
There's such a build-up and there's such a hype, and I can already see it with Washington and with Alex. Everybody's talking about it. Every city he goes to, every game he plays, it becomes mentally draining.
There, there's a slot to Strom, then Ovechkin backhand off the post. Yeah. Center pass. Ovechkin jammed it wide.
Now he hasn't scored in his last 4 games, but it'll be task number 1 here for the Jets to try to shut down Alex Ovechkin.
Shoulder to shoulder with one of the game's all-time greats.
History in the making.
Game by game, you're waiting for him to score a goal, because that's what he does. He scores goals.
Alex Ovechkin rumbling through center with Strom on the drop. Ovechkin closing. Snapshot here. How's that for 801? Woo! Tied now, second all time.
So we're one goal away, and it had previously been stated that, you know, maybe an empty netter would not be the best way to score the last one.
6 attackers for Winnipeg. Empty net waiting. Jensen plays it ahead. Picked by Connor, played onto Ovechkin.
I mean, we was making the plays, and he passed back to me for some no reason when he has to shoot.
Alex Ovechkin at the line, feeds it. Kuznetsov doesn't want to shoot it.
I'm not sure Ovi wanted to shoot it either.
I don't want to score the empty netter.
I knew if I'm not going to pass back and I'm just going to score, that 20,000 people just going to be there, and I'm just kind of like thinking, man, what are you doing?
So like, I'm already like, I give it to Kuzi, I'm relaxing, and he passed me back.
Give it back to you.
Yeah, I was like, oh. Everybody was waiting for it. Family, fans. It was a tremendous feeling, you know, almost crying.
Good job, Dave, baby. Great job.
Attaboy, nice job.
Absolutely wonderful to do it here on home ice.
You know, I was so impressed when I saw other team.
Yeah, that's incredible.
All the players stand to shake Alex's hand.
Rarely do you see this, but this is such a historical moment.
You're the best, Ovi. Congrats. Thank
you. You kind of think about what's going through his mind, how big of an accomplishment this is. I got kind of butterflies, nervous, goosebumps for him.
But for me, it's always nice to hear his speech after. You can see he's nervous and he's excited in a good way, you know. And for me, those moments that put him in that situation, it's unforgettable memories.
Oh yeah.
I always said, without you guys, I would never have that accomplished, those numbers. It's pretty special. Don't cry right now, but yeah, I love you guys. Thank you very much.
Yeah. After that, kids, Sergei and Leah was in the locker room. It's great. It's nice. They're gonna have it on a video. It's gonna be for the rest of their lives.
Of course, I'm very happy that he now on the second place, of course. But also, I'm very proud of him to be such a good father as he is. So I think it's the main thing for me as his wife.
After you beat Gordie Howe, after you pass him, the late great Gordie Howe, is it start to seem more real for you to get Gretz's now?
No.
Still not?
Still not. If it's going to be like 10 goals or 20 goals, maybe. But it's still like, can you imagine like what can happen?
In that time?
In that time, yeah.
To get to that number?
Yeah, maybe injury, maybe everything can happen.
True.
So like I'm not the guy who said like, oh yeah, like I'm going for that.
Linden is pressured. Gretzky in front. Saved by Flaherty. The rebound. Score! The 894th NHL goal. It's taken a long time.
That number is massive. You know, for Wayne to be able to do that was incredible.
Stanley, the all-time leading professional goal scorer.
I try to put it in perspective. If a young player were to come into the league now, and he were to play 20 years of hockey, he would have to score something like 45 goals a year for all 20 years.
Gretzky has the hat trick!
Oh, who would have believed this?
His career obviously was unbelievable. But now Alex is knocking on the door and he's chasing it down.
Fire! Score! The timer! Forget it! Beautiful move! He scores!
If there's anyone that can catch Wayne, it's Alex.
Ovechkin alone, fired, score!
Especially in this era where the goaltending's gotten better, the game's gotten faster. You know, here's Ovi still scoring 50 goals every year and putting himself in that conversation.
Ovechkin with a fancy move of his own, and he finishes!
15 years ago, no matter how great a career we thought Alex was going to have, I would have thought that's pretty unfair expectations. But he's going to make a run at it.
Alex Ovechkin, dangalicious!
Doesn't matter what team you root for, you're seeing something this special take place. It's what legends are made out of.
Only one great left to hunt down, and that's the great one.
Gordie was genuinely happy and thrilled for me that I broke his record. And that's the way I'll feel for Alex, that everything I have in my career, I'm proud of. When he does break the record, hopefully I'm there to be one of the first people to shake his hands.
It's great to be in this kind of position. Then what if, you know?
Joined now by ESPN analyst, former NHL goaltender, Rick DiPietro. Rick, okay, take us back. You're in the league when Alex Ovechkin comes into the league. First impressions when you first saw him on the ice as an opponent. Well, you would pay attention, right? Like you would pay attention to the draft. You'd hear all the noise about who was coming out, and then you see him. And then, his size was one of the first things. And then you saw, you had the tinted visor, you had the yellow laces, you had, the string tied to his pants that was kind of hanging down. Mm-hmm. And then you saw the shot. Yeah. And that was the first thing you saw. Like I can remember the first time he takes a shot and you could feel it. Like, whoa, this is heavy. This is a little bit different. Yeah, again, this is pre-iPhone. Internet video is not quite that full quality yet. So he is a bit of a mystery, right, coming into the league. I'm curious from the normal hockey norms of that time. Take us back again. They've changed a little bit since then. We've seen some of the personalities into the league and how the game is played. But did he stand out from the normal hockey norms at all? Like he was a bit of an iconoclast. Well, you know what it was for me? It was just the idea of, some of the Russian players you had played against, the Burrays, the Fedorovs. And then you saw him and his style was different. It was more, it was more physical. Like he would come in and he would punish the defenseman. And he still had the touch and all the, the hands and everything else that a great goal scorer would have. But like he made you pay a price. Like the defensemen knew, they would always come to me like, hey, can you handle the puck a little bit more? Because I don't want to, I don't want to take this all game long. Because he wears you down with his size. I think that was the one thing that really stood out. And, when someone is that skilled and is willing to make you pay the price the way that he did, I mean, it really was intimidating for a lot of guys. Yeah, obviously he shot it like Brett Hull, which we saw, and Mike Bossy, but then we ran people over as well. So that's an impact that, again, nobody really had on the sport at that time. Well, you know what it was? A guy like that, a goal scorer like that, what you would say to yourself and what, coaches would say to you is, be physical with this guy. Right, try to get him off his game.
Good luck.
Good luck, right? Because then, by the time you're trying to get physical with him, you don't even realize that he's the one being physical with you. Like, it wouldn't take him off his game. He thrived with that kind of physicality. And
I think a defenseman quickly realized, like, when he's coming, like, let's get rid of the puck as soon as we can because he's going to hit us hard.
He scored 5 times against you, Rick.
Not bad.
Yeah, from what you remember, again, what made him such a tough read coming down the wing and dealing with him that maybe other players didn't have that to offer?
Well, I think it's a shot. I mean, he reminds me a lot of, or at the time reminded me a lot of Brett Hull. I played with Brett Hull, you know, World Cup, and I actually thought while we were practicing that he was purposely not trying to score on me, like it was too easy, like I'm just going to hit post because the shot was that good. Mm-hmm. But it's just his shot is different. It really is. It's, I mean, it's partly his curve, it's his strength, it's all of it, but I mean, his shot gets on you so fast and it's so heavy that, like, even, again, even if you think you know where it's going or you're there early in set, it's still, I mean, it's moving around. It just, it's really unique and it makes it really difficult to save it. Mm.
We have to talk about the one-timer because, you know, to me, I said it's like he's waiting for the bus. He stands there. His knees aren't even bent. He's relaxing because he wants to save his legs for the shot, right? But why is he so effective from that dot?
That's his office, man. I mean, you just know, again, every pregame meeting, every penalty kill meeting, it's always the same thing. Like, let's try to cheat to OV. Mm-hmm. Let's make sure he can't get the puck. And as much as you try, it seems like they find a way somehow, some way to get him the puck. And as a goalie, you just want to make sure you're there early, you're set, and give yourself the best chance. But it's just his ability to combine with the curve, the flex on his stick, his lower body strength, all of it. Like, if you watch him, the torque he gets from his body down to when he gets that whip on his stick, it's just there's no one better. And it's what, I mean, it's that combination that makes him the greatest goal scorer of all time.
Yeah, you see hockey players warm up before games down underneath the arenas. Usually they're playing soccer, and just the massive size of his lower body is you can mention the engine where his power.
Well, you don't even, that's the one thing. I mean, do you notice about him? And when you get a chance to meet him in person, because you hear your defenseman talking about it all the time.
You're
like,
right.
Oh my God, this guy, he's so heavy. Like, you try to hit him and you're the one that ends up taking the brunt of it. But then you see him with his equipment off and you're like, my God, this guy's like 250, 260, like, and he's built. Yeah, he really is a specimen.
Yeah, hockey equipment hides players' true physique, and that's, he's a great example of that. Of course, you know, obviously great for you. Your dream come true. You make the NHL, and as we celebrate great hockey players like Alex Ovechkin, their legend only grows. So I imagine for you, the memories start to become even more valuable to you. I got to play against this guy. So what are some of yours when you think about those moments?
Well, it was always exciting to play against him. You play against the greats, you know, him, Sid, like all those great players. It was a challenge because you knew that the last thing you wanted to be was on, you know, SportsCenter's top 10 getting lit up by Alexander Ovechkin. So there were times during, you know, penalty shots that I remember making saves on him. But I mean, he's one of those guys that to this day, kids will come up and ask me, like the kids that I coach, but what was it like to go against Alexander Ovechkin? Did you stop Alexander Ovechkin? So now that I know he's only scored 5 goals on me, I can use that to my benefit. But he was one of the guys that you would know you'd look forward to playing the Capitals and trying to do your best to stop him.
Do you remember any of those 5? Can you still see one coming after? Maybe even one that you saved, but can you still actually see the puck coming off his stick?
Yeah, you know what I remember is because I would purposely cheat. Like, I would know, like, if you know, it was Backstrom or whoever it was to my left, not much of a shot risk. I said, listen, if he beats me with that, that's fine, but I'm going to make sure I get over here. And you could actually, it's funny, the one of the goals I remember him scoring on me, I could see the puck roll. It's like slow motion. The puck rolled up on his stick, and it was on edge. And the second it rolled on edge, I was like, I have no chance.
Luckily, we don't have to talk about this. And it's true a sense because Ovi does have 1 Stanley Cup championship. But let's say he hadn't had that at this time. Would that have affected his legacy, not only going into the record and perhaps breaking it, but even when it was all said and done?
I think it probably would have.
Yeah.
I mean, for him, he'll go down as the greatest goal scorer of all time, but I think he wants more than that. Mm-hmm. I think he wants to be considered one of the greatest players of all time. And then you remember the talk between, you know, it was about him and it was about Sidney Crosby, and Sidney Crosby was able to, you know, get his team to the finish line and win Stanley Cup.
Early.
And he hadn't been able to do it yet. Could he turn himself into a complete player and do all those little things necessary to lead his team to a Stanley Cup? And I think that's why you saw the kind of celebration that you saw, because it was a relief. He finally had done it. Like, he had achieved everything else, and it was just that one thing he needed to do, and good for him, he did it.
Yeah, the Vegas Golden Knights to get that first and only cup so far for Alex Ovechkin. How did his game change, you know, to enable him to help lead the Caps to a Stanley Cup? It seems like some players who, because of the situation their team is in, it does take them a while. It's not their fault. It's just there's not enough good players around them. So what do you need to do? What did he have to do to at least help that become a better chance?
Well, I think you don't know what you don't know, right? Mm-hmm. And it does take some time, and I think Barry Trotz did a good job of kind of teaching him what it was going to take. And I think the great leaders, and I don't care what the sport is, the Tom Brady's, the LeBron James, all those great guys, they almost, because they're always doing things right. They're always doing them how they're supposed to be done. They're doing the little things, shift in, shift out, whatever it is. It's a sense of guilt from your teammates. Well, if he's doing it, if he's the best player and he's doing it, then we all have to do it. So he raises the level of everyone else, and I think it took him a minute to realize that he could have that kind of effect on his team. Mm-hmm. I think McDavid, you saw that from last year in the playoffs. Mm-hmm. It's doing it. It's every shift going out there and doing all the little things it takes on both sides of the puck. And I think he learned that, and his teammates fed off of it.
Ovechkin's always been a popular player with the kids, too, as you mentioned, when he came in the league. Yellow laces, tinted visor. But the victory lap after winning the cup, I think, endeared him to a lot of people, especially in North America, with the way he celebrated. When I was a kid, the Russians that came into the league, they had a dour personality about them. You know, they had no freedoms. That was one reason why. So as they slowly got them, he's kind of that new generation of Russians who has a big personality, and he had a really good time.
Well, mostly you think stoic, right? You think those Russian teams, you think stoic. I'll tell you what, though, having played with a lot of Russians, they have a good time.
Yeah.
And they're a lot of fun to hang out with. But I think what it did was made him relatable. Mm-hmm. Right? And that's what fans want to see. They want to see you enjoy what you do, because there's every fan that would say, I would do what he does for free. And when they see a guy like him at his level have, you know, that kind of, you know, excitement, as if he was a kid, and you said, you know, if I won a Stanley Cup, I would celebrate like, well, I'd celebrate like that. That's exactly how I would celebrate.
Right. He is an extrovert, and he likes to have a good time. Always has. He did those silly commercials locally in Washington when he first came into the league. Didn't matter what he looked like in his own mind. What impact do you think that championship, that Stanley Cup victory, had on his game and really chasing this record as well? Do you think it helped?
I did think it helped. Yeah, because I think he saw what he was fully capable of doing. I think, you know, there's again, I mean, it takes a minute for you to actually realize, you know, what are the things that I need to do on a consistent basis to take me to that next level. And once he saw it and he got the results that he was looking for, he realized, you know, as good as I am now, I can take this thing to another level. Mm. And you're seeing a guy right now that even at, you know, 37 years old, mm-hmm. is still playing at the highest level and is showing no signs at all of slowing down.
He'll get 50 goals again this year with a hot finish. But, yeah, by already having the cup, he can now go for this record maybe with no guilty conscience.
It frees him up.
It would have been harder.
Right. It frees him up. There's less pressure. I mean, he got it. And now anything, he's already said, I'm not going to be part of a rebuild. Mm-hmm. He's still going to go chase that cup.
Yep.
But now it's, you know, rather than focus, it's almost it's a selfish record, right? The goal scoring is a selfish record, but he's got the cup, so he's got that in the bank. Now we can chase after this record and hopefully, you know, as far as he's concerned, win another cup on the way.
Wayne Gretzky retires with 894 career goals. At the time, the NHL was in a severe scoring slump around the league. There's no way anyone thought anyone would approach 894 goals. What did that record at the time mean for the sport of hockey, that 894 as Wayne exits the game?
I think it meant a lot. Mm-hmm. I really do, because I think when you look at the four major sports, I think hockey takes a back seat. But when you hear the name Wayne Gretzky and you talk about his records, I mean, you're sitting at a bar with your buddies and you start going back and forth about football, baseball, basketball.
It's Babe Ruth stuff, right?
Right.
It was a Babe Ruth number.
Well, just not that, just all his records, like his points in a season. And you say, like, these are untouchable records. Like, it made hockey relatable to the other sports. And, I mean, he's the great one.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the nickname says it all.
Yeah, I figure, you know, Babe Ruth, Wilt Chamberlain in basketball, records you just laugh at. And maybe Tom Brady will be that guy, you know, with his Super Bowl championships. What do you think it would mean to have the record broken to Wayne by Alex Ovechkin, the Canadian legend? Here comes this Russian from, they're big international rivals, as you know. What do you think it'll mean for Wayne? Because he'll likely be in the arena as he gets closer, and they could be a part of the festivities.
I don't care what anyone says. No one wants to see their record get broken.
Right.
But if it were to get broken, I mean, it's being like Wayne Gretzky wasn't known as a goal scorer, right? I mean, the fact that he has the record is just a testament to how good he was as a player. But I mean, you're talking about having your record broken by, I mean, you can just watch him play. Like he was put on this planet to score goals, and that's exactly what he does consistently year in, year out. And if anyone was going to break it, as much as you don't want to see it broken, if you're Wayne Gretzky, like this guy was meant to be the one to do it.
Another curious factor is, the fan angle. Other sports, when a guy approaches a record, sometimes they don't want it to be broken. Sometimes they don't care. Curious, the average NHL fan, as this, because some still don't believe it's going to happen. So in 2 years, when he's about five away and they know it's going to happen, what do you think the reaction is going to be around the league?
I want to give you credit because you said something before we even started doing this, and I think it's true. I think you said he's more likely to score 1,000 goals than he is to not break the record. Right. He's going to break the record.
Right.
Like it or not, he'll break the record. I think it's huge.
Yeah.
Because I think this is one of those records you looked at and said it's impossible.
When you look at this greatness story, what do you think in the end, it's a tough word, it's a big word, is Alex Ovechkin's legacy?
He's the greatest goal scorer of all time.
Wow.
And one of the greatest to ever play the game. Mm. That's what will be said about him whenever he decides. Because this guy, with the shape he keeps himself in, mm-hmm. I mean, he can play as long as he wants.
I think probably consider, you know, when people thought about the Mount Rushmore of hockey, it's Gordy, it's Bobby Orr, it's Wayne.
Oh, it's Ovechkin's up there.
And then he's right there, you know, Mario. It's like, it's tough to crack the top 10 in this.
Well, sport. But he has to be, though, right? Yeah. I mean, you're talking about the greatest goal scorer in the history of the sport. And, I mean, the consistency, the longevity. Like, who knows how much longer he wants to play?
Right.
Like, I mean, if his team is competitive and he's winning and, you know, he's got young kids, they want to be around the rink. I mean, this guy is he's a physical specimen, and I think he still loves them. He still loves the game, and that's right. The most important thing, because most guys that retire, it's not the games. We love playing the games. It's all the off-season, the grind mm-hmm. that guys get sick of. But, I mean, right now he's having the time of his life, and he's still playing at a really high level.
Yeah, we're seeing NFL players play in their mid-40s.
Right.
If he does that, he will get 1,000 career goals. What do you think this chase, as it really ramps up now in these next couple of years, the chase for 895, that would make him the number one record holder, passing Wayne Gretzky, 894 ties it. What would it mean to the sport? What's it going to mean, do you think?
I think this is going to be huge for the sport. I think any sports fan, just a sports fan in general, if you're an NFL fan or you're an NBA fan, I think we all are attracted to greatness. There's something about it. We want to see greatness. And what this is doing is it's transcending the NHL.
Where does this record stand among some of the other sports' big unbreakable records?
I think it has to be at the top of the list. Yeah. I don't think that Cal Ripken's streak will ever be broken just because of how we do load management and everything else. But, right. I mean, this was a record that anyone that you talk to was like, no, there's no chance this is going to happen. Because, I mean, goalies are getting better. You know, defensively, teams are getting better. At a time with all the clutching and grabbing, the goal scoring was down. How can we increase goal scoring? And he's found a way just with his consistency to every year. You just pencil him in knowing he's going to be right around that 50 mark, and he's going to do it.
Yeah.
And it's going to be amazing to watch.
Yeah, since he's been in the league, scoring's kind of gone like this, right? But like you said, he's always the same, year after year. NHL on ESPN presents Greatness. For Rick DiPietro, I'm John Butchergoss. Thank you so much for watching.